Hey guys, I know it's late, but if you're up and want to do a midnight Bible study, I'm up to it. Pretty pumped. John had a gig here in San Antonio with Journey, and I'm just getting back to the room, so he's all wired up. And I've been working on my book. You should see my desk, my computer, all a mess here today, but it's been awesome. But I was studying the Word, just thinking about some things in Romans chapter 5. So let's go over there. Why don't you text about 5 people and say, if you're up, let's get on Facebook and pray together and do a Bible study. So good to hear from you guys. Thank you so much for praying for me. Healing, doing great. Anxious to be back on live Facebook a lot and talking to you and everything else. So here's what I want to talk to you about. A lot of people are under pressure. I mean, pressure, and I want to talk to you about that. It seems like pressure from the right, from the left. Maybe you're stressed out about Christmas, about your shopping, your cooking, your list, all the different things you've got to do. But I've got a word for you. First off, Romans chapter 5, see, as we go into it, Romans chapter 5, you guys ready? The NIV says this: not only so, but we also rejoice in sufferings, because we know that suffering produces perseverance, and perseverance character, and character hope. And hope does not disappoint us, because God has poured out his love into our hearts by the Holy Spirit, who he has given unto us. I want to focus on verse 3 and 4. It says, and not only so, but we glory in tribulations. What do you mean we glory in tribulations? Like, I'm excited about tribulation. I'm excited about all the hell that I'm going through, or the bad news I got, or whatever. Well, first off, I'm going to prophesy to you, before you in 2018, you're going to land strong, and what the enemy meant for bad, God is turning around for good. Let me read you the Message version. It says this in verse 3. There's more to come. We continue to shout our praise even when we're hemmed in trouble. Now, this is where I want to take you. Shout your praise even if you're hemmed in trouble. Shout it. It says, because we know how troubles can develop passionate patience in us, and how that patience in turn forges the tempered steel of virtue, keeping us alert for whatever God will do. In alert expectancy such as this, we're never left feeling shortchanged. Quite the contrary. We can't round up enough containers to hold everything God continuously and generously pours into our lives through the Holy Spirit. Christ arrives right on time to make this happen. He didn't and doesn't wait for us to get ready. He presented himself for the sacrificial death when we were far too weak and rebellious to do anything to get ourselves ready. And even if we hadn't been so weak, we wouldn't have known what to do anyway. So as believers, we're people of faith. The just shall live by faith. The Apostle Paul says in verse 3, we glory in tribulations, knowing that tribulation is producing patience, and patience is working experience, and experience is bringing forth hope. Now, why is that so important? Because God's building your resume. You see, the enemy can only back you up till your last experience. When you come through something, you say, hey, God's been faithful. He's the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. And I have experience that if God delivered me from this, if God brought me out of that situation, if God provided for me in 1984, if God opened a door in 1999, if God made a way in 2005, you see, he is the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. I wanted to let someone know, don't stress out. You glory in your tribulation. It doesn't mean like, yeah, man, I'm going through this. It means that I'm going to praise God when I'm hemmed in trouble. To glory means to make boast, to be joyful, to rejoice in tribulation. So tribulations means under pressure. Whenever there's pressure, whenever there is trouble, it means to be pressed, to be vexed. Pressure means the burden or oppressive condition of physical, mental, or social, or economic distress. The action or the force of an opposing force. And it means whenever you find yourself in a situation where you're pressed in and there's pressure, God says rejoice. Because when you're hemmed in trouble, he said, we sing praises. We give praise to God, knowing this, that our trouble, our tribulation, or the pressure that I'm facing is producing patience, and let patience have a perfect work, because it's producing experience, and experience is going to bring forth hope. I just wanted someone to know what the enemy meant for bad, he's going to regret doing in your life. God says in Romans chapter 8, verse 28, that what the enemy meant for bad, God will turn it around for good. He'll look back and he'll go, man, why did I ever scheme that? Why did I ever plot that against them? Why did I ever mess with that person? I came to pray over you. Every person who feels pressure, every person who feels like the enemy's just oppressing you right now, spiritually, mentally, physically, financially, in your family, in your relationships, that pressure is going to pay off. I dare you, put a praise on it. Right now, just lift up your hands and start praising God. Just give God glory and start thanking God. Tell the Lord, I love you, I trust you. Let the enemy know, thank you, you're building my resume. Because right now, under pressure, there's patience being worked out in me. And patience is producing experience. And enemy, you can only back me up to my last experience, because this is another opportunity for God to bring a divine deliverance. So I wanted to prophesy, I wanted to pray, I wanted to let someone know that God is about to swiftly turn things around from you. I hear that suddenly in my spirit. I'm excited. 2019 is going to be a year of advancement, a year of recovery, a year that you see God restore everything. Let's pray together. Under pressure, praise him. Your pressure has a payoff. Amen, Andrea. Destiny, love you too. Erica, God bless you. Sharence, I agree and we claim it. Tony, love the Lord. He is building your resume. Listen, some of your enemies are going to look back and have to eat their words. They're going to be people that sit back and say, look what the Lord has done. He's going to make a way in the middle of nowhere. He'll go before you. According to Isaiah chapter 54, he's going to give you hidden treasures. He's going to enlarge your tent stakes. You're going to produce more in barrenness than the married wife. Isaiah 45, he'll go before you and give you hidden treasures in darkness. He's making a way in the wilderness. God is faithful. Migo, praise God. Anil, thanks. Pressure has a payoff. While my family needed this, my mom and dad, brothers, sisters, babies, husband, just know it. Romans chapter 5, that's where we've been, right? Verse 3. I like the message version. It says, we're hemmed in troubles, and we're going to praise God, because under this pressure, under this stress, it's producing patience. Patience, 7, are perfect work, and it's bringing forth experience, and that brings forth hope. God bless you guys. Just want to share that quick word. I love you. Let's pray together as a community. Sarah, praying for you. Divorce with 7 kids, believing God for restoration. Father, we pray over Sarah right now. We pray over everyone who's hurting, everyone who feels pressure. Let every spirit of weariness be broken off you right now in the name of Jesus. I ask that the Lord wrap his arms of love around you, bring you a peace that passeth all understanding. We come against every fiery dart that has been sent against your mind. We overturn it by the blood of Jesus, and we lift up the name of Jesus over your household, over your life, over your spirit being, over your mind. We cast down every imagination right now. According to Philippians 4, verse 6 and 7, we let our requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, will keep your heart and mind through Christ Jesus. I declare supernatural breakthrough, supernatural, swift, suddenly. Psalm chapter 6, verse 10, God says he'll give a sudden deliverance over your enemies. Expect it, believe it, and know that your pressure as a payoff. God bless you.